Yesterday, in class 9B, I taught the introduction of compound interest and the list of important formulae. Those will be used in this chapter to solve different types of questions. Yesterday, you have seen that always I used to find amount. Why the chapter is related with compound interest? I never use the formula to find CIE. There is a little trick at this point. If you find CIE, that will be a little complicated process. And if you find A amount, that solution will be easy for you. And if you find A, then you can get easy. Yeah, I was at this point. To find amount is easy. Then to find CIE. Because as per the formula, if you find CI, then your formula is minus 1. So this calculation is a little difficult, little complicated. You may do mistake in calculation. So I say, this is my suggestion only. Otherwise, you are free to follow any process. If you find A, that will be easy to calculate. So, I focus to find A. After getting A, you can find CI through this process. CI equal to amount minus principal. And yesterday, I focused these three situations. First situation was, if the interest is compounded annually, A equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N, where N is the number of years. Second, if interest is compounded half yearly, then A equal to P into 1 plus R by 2 by 100 to the power 2N, where N is the number of years. Here, rate of interest is divided by 2. And for different rate of interest in successive years means in the first year it is 5%, in the second year it became 8%, in third year it became 10%. For this, amount equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 into 1 plus R by R2 by 100 into 1 plus R3 by 100, where R1, R2 and R3, these three are different rate of interest for three different successive years. You may have more than three, then automatically it will increase into 1 plus R4 by 100, that become for 4 years. Into 1 plus R 1 plus R5 by 100, that became for 5 years. And after that, we have some basic things to know. As we are seeing these fundamental things, so we will find out, we'll see the variations of questions. First of all, you may be asked to find out amount. Second, you may be asked to find out CI. Third, you may be asked to find out principal. Fourth, you may be asked to find out rate of interest. And fifth, you may be asked to find out the number of years. So these five questions are very fundamentals. Those depend on this formula. After that, you have some different kinds of variations. Those we will see during the solution of the exercise.